Good morning, fourth max students. First, let me tell you the question which you have to write. And the question is differences between assessment and evaluation. Okay, I repeat the question. Write down the differences between assessment and evaluation. Okay. Now, the answer should be based on my video lecture. Okay, the answer should be based on my video lecture, and you have to write a tabular column, assessment and evaluation. Okay, and as you listen to the video lecture, how far have you taken down the most important point? Okay, based on that, I assess today's your performance, today's performance. Okay, and ironically, the topic itself is difference between assessment and evaluation. Okay, so now we will begin. Now we shall know the definition, epistemological meaning of assessment and evaluation. Okay, epistemological meaning, that means origin of words and its meaning, how the word originated in English language. Okay, so in assessment, epistemological meaning of the word assessment is the word assessment, A-S-S-E-S-S-M-E-N-T, is taken from the Latin word. The word assessment is taken from the Latin word accessory, A-S-S-E-S-S-A-R-E, accessory, A-S-S-E-S-S-A-R-E. So in Latin, accessory means fix a tax upon. Okay, fix a tax upon. And another meaning another meaning of the word accessory is to sit beside. From two Latin word. Okay, first word is accessory, A-S-S-E-S-S-A-R-E. Okay, and that means fix your tax upon. Okay, and another Latin word is assessidere, A-S-S-I-D-E-R-E. This is another Latin word, that means to sit beside. A-S-S-I-D-E-R-E, this is another Latin word, and that means to sit beside. So, with the combination of these two words, accessory and accessidere, and this word assessment in English derived. Okay. And, in education, the word ASS, is related to in education. In education, it means, these words are related to ASS, assessment. Okay, assessment or ASS, these words are related, most importantly, in education. Skills, abilities, performance, aptitude, competence. Skills, abilities, performance, aptitude, competence. C-O-M-P-E-T-E-N-C-E. Okay. So, it is assessing students' skills, abilities, performance, aptitude and competence. So, everything is related to the word skill. Thiran. Students today, thiran endalavukku irukku. Okay. Idu dhaan assessment. Every side la evaluation, the epistemological meaning of the word evaluation is it is Again, this word is the in English the word evaluation is taken from French word and also a Latin word. In what is the French word evaluer? E-V-A-L-U-E-R. Evaluer. That means to find the value of. Okay. Latin the word from the word val. Leri, V-A-L-E-R-E, that means to strong, to be well. Okay, taken from two words, French word and Latin word, and French word it is evaluer, E-V-A-L-U-R, that means to find the value of, and Latin word valeri, V-A-L-E-R-E, that means to be strong, to be well. Okay. In education, evaluation is related with the terms the effectiveness of an education system, a program, a course, a instruction, a curriculum. Okay. So, again, let me repeat. In education, evaluation is related with the terms the effectiveness of an education system, a program, a course, instruction, a curriculum. Okay? And assessment is to develop student skills. Okay? Assessment is to develop student skills. I mean, first point, epistemological meaning and its education related terms are over. And the second point is assessment is to improve students' skills, knowledge, and etc. Okay. Evaluation is judging based on some criteria. Okay. Evaluation is judging based on some criteria. And third point is the purpose of your assessment is improving current performance. Okay, the purpose of assessment is improving current performance. Evaluation is a final one, it is passing judgment out of set norms. Evaluation is final one, it is passing judgment out of set norms. Therefore, after evaluation, there is no scope for students to improve. Okay, so after evaluation, there is no scope for students to improve. Okay, see, the most important purpose of assessment is to help our students to improve their performance. Okay, so your grammar, so these all the mistake you did, you improve your grammar, you improve your vocabulary, you improve your tenses. Likewise, teachers would give a feedback to the students, and based on that students are going to improve. But in case of evaluation, it is the final judgment, and the evaluation is based on the set criteria. Okay, so this is this syllabus, and you have to attend the examination, and you have to score 35% of marks. Only if you score 35% of marks, you are qualified for SSLC examination. If you get, even if you get 35 marks, again you have to reappear for the examination. If you score more than 35 and above, you need not to write the examination, certificate will be given to you. Okay. And if you go for higher studies, you have to score more marks. Such is the set norms by the government. Okay. So, cannot be changed, and you are judged. The purpose of evaluation is to judge you. But in case of assessment, it is not so. The purpose of assessment is to help you to improve your performance. Okay. So now, moving to fourth point. feedback is the most essential thing in an assessment. The teacher should give the individual feedback to the student. But in evaluation, the feedback is whether the students. But in evaluation, the feedback is based on whether the students have achieved the set norms or not. Okay. See, third point is this: feedback is the most essential thing in an assessment. The teacher should give individual feedback to the student. Okay. But in case of evaluation, feedback is done whether the students have achieved the set norms or not. Okay. See, in case of assessment, okay. Let me explain, and then I will tell you that is, in case of assessment, the teacher should give individual feedback. Individual feedback should be given to the individual feedback should be given to the student, which I will which I will do very soon. And remember, and as I give you feedback, and let's say I am planning for oral test in the afternoon. Actually, I planned to do it after 10th July, but it seems 10th July is the last regular working day. So after, I mean, we are not very sure. In case 10th July is the last day, then I will do the oral test maybe next week or last week of June. Okay. So daily I will call you 5 students in 10 days. Everything will be over. So based on the oral test also, I will assess you, and at the time I will give you feedback also. Okay. So for 10 days. So these all so this much of days you were absent. So why are you absent? And so mostly you got excellent, mostly you got very good, and mostly you got okay. So why? What is the purpose? What is the reason for this? I will ask this thing, and randomly I will ask you questions, and that is also considered. Okay. So in case we have working days after 10th July, then I will do it in the class itself. But in case 10th July is the last date, I will call you at afternoons. Okay. So this individual feedback is very essential for students, and that should be given by teachers, and that is the most important thing. And in practical life, it is difficult for teachers to give individual feedback, but that is most important thing for any teacher. Okay. When you we as teachers, when we give individual feedback, the students, then only students will improve their performance. Students can improve their performance. Okay. So therefore, teachers giving individual feedback is very important. And but in case of evaluation, marks is said to be the individual feedback. Okay. And when your marks is printed in your mark list, and that's all, it cannot be changed. Okay. So say for example, again, it's okay. Some of you are absent for most of the days. Okay. And when I call them, and sir, I was affected by COVID-19, and for more than 1 month I was affected, and at the time my parents are also affected, and when this is the real situation, then I must consider the things, and okay, for this is a valid reason, so let me give attendance. Though she is really absent in these days, it is a valid reason. Let me consider this one. and I will call principal sir, this particular student is the whole family is affected by this virus, and PS, and this student also got permission from me, and then I will consider in internal marks and assessment. I will consider these things. But in case of evaluation, university exam, if you are absent, even if you have a valid reason, that's all. You are absent, that's all. You are failed, that's all. Okay. So this is a problem in our system of evaluation. Many of the people are reconsidering it, but we don't have choice also. Even if you are sick, and if your mother is sick, your parents are sick, you, whatever the situation may be, you must attend the examination. If you don't attend the examination, that's all your fate. Okay. So this is the case of evaluation. Okay. So the test norms is that you have to attend, you have to in person, நேர்ல வந்து exam எழுதணும். நீயா paper எடுத்துட்டு sorry, paper இல்ல pen எடுத்துட்டு வரணும். Government is not going to give you pen and other things. Paper, pen, pencil and scale and eraser and everything you have to bring, but paper will be given by the government itself. Paper, question paper will be government, and you should have prepared for the exam, and you should have written it. Okay, so based on that you are given marks, and then you are evaluated. Okay, so so this is the situation. This is the norm. This is the set norm by the government, and you don't have the right to change. As a student, you don't have the right to give feedback to the government. We as teachers, we as teachers have more responsibility, and we as teachers should give feedback. This system is a good one. And we as teachers, only based on one examination, it cannot be done. Okay, see, if you are sick on one that particular day and you are absent, for 6 months, for the whole year, you would have studied well. But on one particular day, if you are sick and you are failed. Okay, so this is not the proper way. And so therefore, 70 marks is external and 30 marks is internal. Okay. So daily 3 tests and assignment and everything is considered. Based on that, the 30 marks is given by the individual teacher. Okay. So therefore, your marks is the evaluation is not based on a single day performance. Okay. The 30 days, 30 marks marks are allotted based on the continuous formative evaluation. That is assessment. Okay. 70 marks is based on the one single day performance. Okay, so this is somewhat a balanced one. Okay, so not only based on one the performance of one particular day, so on the whole, what you have done, what kind of hard work you have done, what kind of intelligence that you have, based on that 30 marks internal marks is are given to you. Okay. So both the one day performance and the whole course performance, 6 months course is assessed, and based on that you are evaluated. So this is a somewhat a kind of balanced one. Okay. So evaluation is how far students achieved. This is these are the questions that we are going to ask, and that you do not know. All of a sudden the question paper is given to you, and correct answer should be written by you. Okay, you should write the correct answer. And for this particular question, these are the important points. Have you covered up these points? Have you done any grammar mistakes or not? So based on these set norms, you are evaluated. You don't have the right to change those norms. But we as teachers will give right to the university or to the government, educational board. And the syllabus is difficult, and students find difficult to the question paper is difficult. Likewise, we give feedback, and based on that, the government is responsible should consider the feedback and it should change it. Okay, but at same time the government has full right to accept teachers feedback or not. It is the government has the full rights. Okay, well, whatever the government say, we have to accept it. Okay, so this is the thing. And next point is that in assessment, both teachers and students complement each other and they give feedback to each other. Okay. So in assessment, both teachers and the students complement each other. They give feedback. Okay. Suppose I conduct a class test. Okay, this is the marks. In this way, you have to improve your performance. And students also give the feedback. Sir, you don't understand what do you say. And for today's class is nice. We are able to understand it very clearly. Okay. So compliment. COMPLEMENT. Complement is completeness. So in assessment, teacher feedback and student feedback, then only it is called as complete assessment. When assessment is teachers and students should participate, then only it is the assessment is complete. So teachers and students complement each other. Without student, teacher is nothing, and without without students, teacher is nothing, and without teachers, students are nothing. Okay, so both complement each other. Without students, teacher is nothing, and without teachers, students are going to be nothing. So both complement each other. Both the feedbacks make assessment complete. Okay, but in evaluation, there is no scope for students to give their feedbacks to the government. Only teachers are allowed to give their feedbacks to the government. So this is the case. Students will never be able to give any feedback to the government. If at all, the students can give their feedback to teachers and teachers can give feedback to the government. Under some feedback are possible. Okay, this is the Indian system. Okay, so that's all about the difference between assessment and evaluation. With this, by today, this topic, concept of assessment and evaluation is over. Okay, and let me further, the difference between assessment and evaluation is over. And in English, okay, so in English grammar, what Renuka madam is doing is a kind of assessment in English. Okay, your speaking skills, your writing skills, and these are evaluated by Renuka madam. And I'm not sorry for using the word evaluate. Your speaking skills, your writing skills are assessed by Renuka madam, and this is assessment in English. Okay, as far as English is concerned, your writing skills, your reading skills, your speaking skills, these are the most important thing to teach a language, and how far you have developed these skills, those things are assessed daily by Renuka madam. Okay, so and then see, what I do is that the topics, the textbook, evaluation, and the challenges faced by teachers to teach English language, these are all the topics in the syllabus which I teach, and how far have you grasped these concepts, this knowledge, that I assess by your daily assignment. Okay, so but in case of maths, that is a completely different one. How far have you solved the problem? How far have you derived the formula? And those things are done by maths professors. But these things are done by English professors. And poetry, prose, a novel, drama, and your speaking skills, your reading skills. So this all done by done by English teachers or English professors. Okay, so that's the end of this topic. Concept of assessment and evaluation. Okay, and see in English only at the higher secondary level we have a VIVA. Okay, and so there your reading skills, your speaking skills are evaluated in the final time. Okay, so commission is also a kind of practical examination, and that is a kind of final evaluation. Okay, I don't know whether you will be able to attend the commission or not, but your teaching skills, have you written records or not, everything is evaluated on that one particular day. Okay, but your daily assessment is assessed by individual professors. Okay, so that's all about the topic, concept of assessment and evaluation in English. Next class we will move to next topic in unit 5. Okay, so today's lecture is a lengthy one, but you must do it. Okay, thank you.